Well, after seeing some of the content creators covering the same topic about AMC and GME, saying that they will stop or reduce the content they're going to create about the stocks, I decided to do the same. I won't be making any more AMC's videos. Of course, that's a joke, guys. Come on. I will explain you why, my take on this, why some people are deciding to take another path. And I'll explain you why my path is completely different. So, guys, first of all, my channel wasn't born around the movement of AMC, GameStop, retail investors. My channel has been around since 2012. Of course, I didn't post as often, I didn't produce as much as content, simply because my priorities have been shifted. But for majority of these people who are seeing online covering the same topic, my colleagues, content creators covering the same topic, their channels have been born during AMC, GameStop, retail investments frenzy, right? And to be 100% clear, some of them are doing a great job, but some of them are trying to find their own path moving forward, right? After all these things finish. That's not the case for my channel, because on a daily basis, guys, I'm sharing so many different news, so many different things associated or related to the stock market. What Fed said, what this thinks about the money. If you want to go back and check my videos before AMC, I've been doing a lot of videos about savings, about retirement accounts, everything related to personal finance. So on daily basis, I don't have to show up and make a separate video telling you, hey guys, I'm gonna make that type of a content, I'm gonna make this, I'm gonna make that, because I've been doing that. Like, the channel has been dedicated to personal finance, investing, building wealth, enjoying and spending your life in a way in which you will get the best returns, not only financial returns, but also experiential, like emotional returns, right? And in my opinion, that's the main reason. That's not fear for certainty, like a lot of people are putting out there, that these guys have stopped covering the topic, something big is about to happen, or somebody is threatening them. I hope not. Of course, we are not able to know the whole truth, 100% what actually is happening in their brains, what are their plans, but that's the thing. That's the main goal, in my opinion. This is my take on this. I believe that they want to shift. I believe they want to grow. I believe that they want to walk away at some point from this whole situation with the mindset that they will be able to keep moving forward without talking about the stock. Because, guys, let's face it, a lot of these people are doing YouTube full time, and if they don't get enough views for the following content, this means that they have to go back or find another work on the site, right? They won't be able to do YouTube full time as they usually do with AMC or GameStop. That type of a video was probably the least interesting making for me personally, but I think this is the top of the FUD out there. This is like the peak. This is like the cherry on top of all the FUDs out there. Somebody is threatening other YouTubers, or other YouTubers are selling. I don't know what is the position of each of the people out there, but I believe they're holding, because nothing changed. Honestly, nothing changed in the DD, nothing changed in the structure of the stock, nothing changed on all the short interest. None of the big short sellers cover their position. So if nothing changed, I showed you a couple of days ago, even Meet Kevin, he's still bullish on the stocks, and we all know he's doing a very, very in-depth research on each and every stock. So I will be here, guys, not simply because majority of you are fans, not only most of you are invested with AMC or GameStop, because I'm investing in AMC as well. So first of all the research that I'm doing on a daily basis, I'm doing it for myself. Secondary, I'm posting and sharing with you. That's it. I mean, it will be stupid if I keep doing every single day my own research about the stock, what new, did something change? It will be stupid if I'm not sharing all that with you, right? And thinking about this, probably this is the most weirdest thing ever. If these people who are covered AMC in the past keep doing research, keep doing due diligence on the stock, and not sharing this with you, like not making content, this is probably weird to me. Because this is what I'm doing, right, every single day. I'm checking all the stocks that I own, I'm doing the research, I'm trying to identify, is there any pattern that can identify the future moves of the stock or the company? And I'm sharing this with you, particularly for AMC, right? And this is why I don't understand if these people will stop looking at the charts, if these people will stop doing a DD on the stock because they said they're gonna produce less content, or even they will stop covering the stock. This is a good question. I think this is the real question without any fud on the market. So let me know in the comment section, do you agree with me, or what is your take on this? Subscribe to the channel, check this beautiful Sunday morning view of the New York skyline. Check out the second channel. Very, very informative data, very informative videos and content on the second channel. Like this video, guys, and I hope August will be amazing for the stock and for us individually.